This is a humpback whale, one of the world's largest animals. It can grow up to 18 meters long and weigh up to 40 tons. Recently, however, the humpback whale gained a new feature, a price tag. It is now worth $2 million. But why? Because big whales can help humanity in the fight against climate change. It's an ecosystem service that could be worth millions of dollars per whale, according to new analysis by economists, who asked the question, how much is a whale worth? It's an exceptional way of saving our climate. But how can whales be valued in dollars? And how can these marine mammals have an effect on our climate? Let's put this under the microscope. Whales combat carbon naturally. Big whales, like filter-feeding baleen and sperm whales, help sequester carbon. They hoard it in their bodies, stockpiling tons of carbon apiece, like giant swimming trees. We all know that trees are effective carbon tanks. A mature tree absorbs up to 22 kilos of carbon dioxide each year. But next to these marine giants, there's no comparison. A single whale with an average lifespan of 60 years stores about 33 tons of carbon dioxide. That means one whale is equivalent to 1,500 trees. When a whale dies, its carcass sinks to the bottom of the sea. The carbon stored in it is taken out of the atmospheric cycle for hundreds or even thousands of years. But whales do even more to fight climate change. They provide a special eco-service called the whale pump. In the depths of the ocean, whales feed on tiny marine organisms like plankton and krill. Then they return to the surface where they release huge fecal plumes, floating masses of pee and poo rich in iron, phosphorus, and nitrogen, exactly the substances plankton needs to grow. And more plankton is just what the planet needs. Plankton captures an estimated 40% of all the CO2 produced worldwide, and it contributes at least 50% of the oxygen in our atmosphere. It would take 4 Amazon rainforests to capture the equivalent amount of CO2. In recent years, scientists have discovered that plankton is blooming along the migratory routes of whales. Traveling between their breeding and feeding grounds, whales excrete nutrition into oceans all over the world, iron into cold waters, and nitrogen and phosphorus into warm seas. So the more whales there are, the more plankton there is, and the more carbon can be absorbed. That's great geoengineering. But what about the price tag? How can these whale characteristics be converted into dollars and cents? That's where a nature-loving economist steps in. He wanted to drive home how important whales are, so he put it in terms people could understand. Money. He took the per-ton price of carbon and multiplied it by the quantity that a single great whale could store in its body. The result? Each whale weighed out to an average of $2 million. This was a surprise even to the expert himself, Ralph Chami.
The $2 million came out. And I was in total shock. I mean, I was convinced I had made a mistake.
But there was no mistake, and Chami went on.
If you take 2 million and you multiply by what we have right now, well, the total population of whales is about 1.25, but I'm talking only about the great whales. And if you look only at the great whales, you're talking about over $1 trillion in terms of the value of this.
Chami knew that giving whales a price tag would get some attention in his world. But how did he calculate the price?
you could easily do this exercise without using any pricing. You just figure out how much carbon the whales capture directly or indirectly, and then you compare it to what trees and mangroves and salt marshes and other creatures capture, and you can do the same calculations. But I thought using the dollars and cents also allows me to use the market in order to you know, get money and galvanize also other kinds of mechanism, market mechanism, that would help us get the whole society around saving the whales.
About 500 years ago, before commercial whaling started, there used to be between 4 and 5 million whales swimming in the world's oceans. It's well known that overexploitation led to a serious decline in many of the world's whale populations. According to the International Whale Commission, many species are now in the process of recovering, although not all. A new study has also established that in the western South Atlantic, humpback whales have recovered strongly, and their current abundance is close to 25,000 whales. The population status is much more optimistic than previously thought, and abundance should reach its pre-exploitation level within the next 10 years. Currently, there are more than 1 million whales in our oceans, but can they all return to their pre-whaling numbers?
Realistically, in light of what's happening to our planet and the change that's happening so quickly for us, I thought it was much more useful for us to ask, how long will it take for us to double the population, rather than try to figure out how long it go back to pre-whaling. I don't think it's realistic. Especially because each whale species is reacting differently. If we were to kind of do a rough estimate based on the data we have, it would take over 30 years to double the population.
Even a slight recovery of the population would help the planet. A 1% increase in plankton productivity would capture hundreds of millions of tons of additional CO2 each year. A scenario equivalent to the sudden appearance of 2 billion mature trees.
I truly believe that we should be doing something about it by coming out and saying the whales are the global treasure, or in the language of economics, international public good.
Hopefully, that enormous value of whales will drive politicians and other powerful people to strengthen the protection of whales. We have to save the whales, because they are saving us.